back to another video in this playthrough for GMT Games Prime Minister. We are playing the Clockwork C2 scenario, climbing the Greasy pole. And with that, we will just jump right back into the action. Welcome back to a new session. A couple of things that I noticed from the last session that I need to tidy up. The first thing is I actually, the designer, Paul Hellyer, let me know on BGG, I don't need to track my own VP in this scenario. It's just, I don't need to do it. The Prime Minister's VP is acting as a timer, so I have until he gets to 100 to complete my objectives, but my VP simply don't matter. The other thing, as I noticed that I moved this one too far, I moved it from 13 to 16. I should have moved it from 13 to 15, so I'm just going to move that back. And so to start this turn, we are going to give the Prime Minister his 4 victory points. And then the opposition leader is going to start acting. Now, flattery is still a futile action. He and I are 3 apart, but if flattery, if he's got a lead of 3 or more, it's considered futile. So he is going to essentially spend his time debating. Now, both of these bills are in the same position, which is they're both at 320. And they are both essentially there, the same tiebreaker. So I am simply going to choose the Oxford University Act, and he's going to spend 2 cubes driving that down. Now on my turn, I'd like to do something on the elections track just because of where that is. But I also want to debate this once. And the reason I want to debate this once is if I drop this to 310, then if he takes 3 actions on it, he's only going to get to 340. So then we got to draw an uncertainty card, and it's possible that he could end up failing to pass this bill, which would be excellent. So I'm going to spend 1 to do a level 1 campaign action, and I think I'm going to do it with the farmers. I am, in fact, going to do it with the farmers. I can't do it with the conservatives because they're already maxed out. So I'm going to drop him from 13 to 15. And then with my next action, I'm going to debate, and I will drop this down to 340. Sorry, I will drop this down to minus 40, which puts it now at 310. So then we go over to the Prime Minister. We start, of course, with an event, and it's a by-election. So if the round off the PM's election projections to the nearest 10, and if it's less than his current, but he's at 360, so no, he's currently projected to win this election, so he's not going to do that. But what he is going to do is he's going to use his, he's going to defend this bill 3 times. So he's going to do it once here, and then here he will just do it because it is the only bill. It's the only bill in his kind of passable range. So he's going to do it 3 times. That takes that bill to 340. So now we go to bill resolution, and he's going to try to resolve that bill, but he has to draw an uncertainty card, and it's a minus 1. It's a whole lot of nothing. So that bill passes. And so for passing that bill, he gets 2 victory points, and he goes up in Scotland. So he's going to go up in Scotland, and so that puts him back to the 15 on the track. Okay. Well, that was unfortunate. It would have been lovely to get a minus 11 uncertainty card, but of course, the odds aren't that high, so that was perhaps a little bit of wishful thinking. All right. So now we don't have a challenge, and there is no election because there's still a bill on the board. So I have given the Prime Minister 4 victory points. He's up to 59, and I've reset all of the action cubes, and so we are now back around to actions. So this bill is now at 310. So, unfortunately, the one thing that means is that the opposition leader is going to waste a cube because his attack range is 300 to 350. So he is going to waste a cube, sort of actually defend. In fact, he's going to waste both cubes, isn't he? Because that takes it down to 290. So now it's at 290. So he'll spend 1 cube debating that. And then he's going to spend his last cube campaigning with the gentry. The conservatives, again, they're maxed out. So he's going to spend a cube campaigning with the gentry, which will do that. Now, for myself, the prime minister, I think, is going to spend, probably going to spend all three actions, barring him having to spend some on the event. He's going to spend it all campaigning. So I'm going to try to at least keep pace with what he's going to do. And I've got either farmers or Ireland. I'm going to spend both of my cubes. And I will take us up two with the farmers. Actually, that taking us up two with the farmers actually takes it down five. So because that last jump is actually a jump of three. So that's actually pretty good. That actually gets me down there. And now we shift over to the prime minister. So as always, we draw an event. So if his standing is less than or equal to 12, it is. And if the highest bill is greater than or equal to 340, it isn't. So he will, he is not going to be doing any debating, because at best case scenario, he could raise this bill to minus 30, which would mean that it was at 320. So he doesn't have any chance of passing it. So he's not going to waste his time on that. So that means he's going to start by campaigning with the middle class, then the gentry, and then actually I'm going to hold on to that because he may be pegged on the liberals. He is. So he campaigns in the middle class. He campaigns in the gentry. That gets him four. So that's going to take him to 12. So that extra jump there helped because it kept him down a little bit. And then he is going to hobnob with his last action, because going up in the liberals is futile. So he draws a supporter card. It doesn't say hold for election. It isn't a level two. So we just put it there. We'll resolve it at the start of his next turn. So with that, the prime minister withdraws this bill because it was going to fail anyway. And what that means is that the opposition leader gains a standing and the prime minister loses a standing. I don't think anything else happens. Nope. So that also means that the, I'm going to just do this right now, is that now the opposition leader has three action cubes. So we now actually are going to be able to do a lot more than the prime minister. So we hopefully we can start gaining steam here. We're very close to a challenge being possible. So mostly I think we need to focus on elections from here on out. But right now we actually have to run an election because there are no bills left on the board and the delayed marker is off the board. So we have to run an election. So the election projections is currently at 347. So he is at 347. So we shuffle the uncertainty deck. Wow. Minus 12. Holy cow. So that takes him from 347 down to 335. So that gives him 340. So he gets two victory points for winning. However, he gets two victory points for winning. However, he gets no victory points because he lost seats. So he is at 340. Now let's look at partisanship. So he's got 200 from there and that's it. So he's got 200 partisans and that will give him 140 moderate. So he's still kind of in a balanced situation. So he's mostly going to be, in fact, I think he's almost certainly going to be generally picking all bills because M and P bills are still not going to be able to get into his defense range. So that is the end of that turn. And with that, we are going to, again, loop back to the beginning. Actually, we're going to move that back onto the board. Okay, so we have, given the Prime Minister's VPs, we have reset the action cubes. So now it's bill selection. So we have to do bill selection. And these, well, there's not much to choose between these, frankly. But both of them are actually not too bad for me because if he passes them, he gets two VPs and that's all. So we're going to put that one in there because it has a higher projected vote total. Now, he is still drawing from the cross-party deck because his moderates or partisans are not greater than... sorry, his partisans are not greater than 250. So we're still drawing from the cross-party build deck. So let's see. Let's put that there. One, two... There we go. I'll do it that way. And let's take a look at this. So anything that is a moderate bill, he is going to be getting rid of. Wow, these are not particularly good results for him. These are excellent results for me. So basically everything is worth two VPs. He's going to prioritize the Commonwealth of Australia Act because it would get him a supporter. And then he's going to prioritize these. I think he's going to prioritize the ones with the highest in-range vote projection. So he is going to prioritize the Copyright Act and the Arsenic Act. An act to regulate the sale of arsenic. That sounds like a good thing. So he is going to do that. So I am going to, on my turn, I am definitely going to be focusing on trying to make this bill unpassable, because if I do that, basically he'll get no really good benefits this turn. Nothing will go up on the standing track from passing bills. So it'll be kind of a wash there. So those are the three bills that we have selected. Okay, so now it is the opposition leader's turn. And this is the only bill that is in his attack range, I think. This bill is at 370. This bill is at 370. So he's going to spend all three of his actions debating the Commonwealth of Australia Act. I think there's going to be a lot of activity around this bill this turn because these at 370, these are just going to pass. So a lot of activity is going to focus here. Now, when I look at my turn, I definitely want the Prime Minister to spend time on this bill as opposed to campaigning, which he's going to do, but we also don't want him to pass this bill. So I got to be mindful of that. So I'm going to start by drawing a supporter. See if I can maybe get something that gives me like a level two ability. I don't, but I do get to go up with workers. Farmers are pegged, so I get to go up with workers, which is kind of good because that's not a constituency I can campaign with natively. And then I'm going to debate. I'm going to debate this and I'm going to drive it minus 40. So now it's at 300. So it remains in his attack range or in his defense range. So he will probably spend time debating it, but I think it's at a place where we can prevent him from passing it. You know, and you know, hopefully not, he won't spend a lot of time on campaigning. So now it's over to the Prime Minister, and we start with an event. And so if his standing is greater than or equal to 9, it is, and if the highest bill is 320 or greater, definitely, he's gonna spend a cube campaigning with the farmers. So he is going to drive his support with the farmers up, moving the election projections to there. Now with his next two, oh, you know what? I realized I should have played this card when I drew it. So when you will hold cards when they are marked as like a hold for election, and you will hold them here as the clockwork player when they come from bill resolution. But when you draw them inside your turn, you should have just played them. So, you know, I should have just gone ahead and played this when I got it. So it's going to drive, the influence action is futile. So it's going to drive us down one with the farmers. So that drives us down one with the farmers. We lose 3. That's quite big. Have to get that back somehow. Okay. So then with his next two actions, in the first case, he is not going to debate the highest bills because those are utterly passable. So he is going to go up one with the middle class for his first action. So that takes him to 17. Good Lord, he's way over there now. And then he's going to campaign with the gentry, and he's continues to get further and further away. This, I don't know how I'm ever going to get him out of government. And so that is it, because his third cube is right there. All right, so now we go on to bill resolution, and he's going to resolve one of these bills at 370, because this bill is not in his attack range. Or, sorry, this bill is not in his selection range for passing. These bills are fundamentally the same, so it doesn't really matter which one we do, so we'll do the Copyright Act. So that gives him 2 victory points and nothing else. But with that, I think we'll pause the video here and we'll pick it up again in the next video. Thanks for sticking around to the end of the video. I hope you're enjoying the video, the playthrough of Prime Minister, as well as the channel in general. Please leave comments with suggestions on things like other games that you'd love to see come to the channel or improvements that can be made to the channel. And we will see you in the next video on Agility Snips Gaming Table.